So Bitcoin dominance has been really rocketing lately, and many people are wondering, will altcoins ever recover? This video is going to be all about that topic. So if you're curious or if you have your own opinion, then sit back, relax, and just keep on watching. Hi everyone, I'm Kevin from Bitcoin for Beginners, and this channel is all about education. So if you're about that life and want to keep on learning more in this space, then just smash that like button, subscribe down below, hit that notification bell, and enjoy the episode. So if we take a look at this total market capitalization and we look at Bitcoins in orange, if you see at the end, it's now at around like 65% higher than it's been for a long, long time since like the start or middle of 2017. For many years now. And so this has really been a Bitcoin maximalist wet dream. They are all very sure about themselves and that they are right. And if you take a look at some altcoin pairings with BTC, these are the altcoin to BTC pairings. A lot of them have been showing signs of capitulation in the charts. For example, this one is of EOS and this one's of Ethereum to BTC. Now their USD charts are doing much better and holding somewhat steady, but Bitcoin has been rocking and sort of decoupling from these altcoins lately. It's even interesting to note that Tone Vase pointed out that people like Sunny Decree and Ian Bellina, YouTubers who have gotten kind of famous trading different altcoins, investing in altcoin projects, have started to say that they're becoming Bitcoin maximalists. This is stunning, and this may be a sign of capitulation as well. So this has gotten many people to be very scared for their altcoin bags and have been asking the question, will altcoins ever recover, or should I just sell all of them and only be in Bitcoin, or just give up on the crypto space as a whole? Well, personally, I think altcoins will recover, but of course not all of them, only the solid ones. And in the rest of this video, we're going to kind of dive into my reasoning and so forth. But first, let's take a look at Wayback Machine. This is an archive of CoinMarketCap 5 years ago. And of course, Bitcoin was up top and Ripple, Litecoin are still here. But a lot of the other ones in the top 20 are really dead projects and no longer useful or in development or being maintained. Like Aurora Coin, Pure Coin, Mastercoin, Namecoin, ProtoShares, Quark, all of these are irrelevant pretty much. And so it's not guaranteed that the ones that we think are even in the top coins are going to be alive or still developed later on, 5 years later, especially if you're in this space for a long-term hold. However, this space is a lot different than it was 5 years, even 2 to 3 years ago, right? It's much more mature. For example, I'm just going to show you some examples like the Enterprise Ethereum Alliance has hundreds of corporations joined to kind of explore Ethereum and their business practices. We also got IOTA partnering with Jaguar Land Rover, and we got VeChain partnering with Walmart China. These are just a few of the examples. Furthermore, many projects have very large war chests, and they're using it to grow their ecosystem. For example, EOS has invested in Voice.com, which is going to be a more transparent social media platform. A lot of people say there's a big need for this. And so they're investing a lot of money into this, and that already gives this project a higher chance of success and would prop up the EOS ecosystem. Besides that, you can just take a look at all the work being done building dApps on a variety of different networks, Ethereum, EOS, Steam, Loom, and so forth. This is state of the dApps. And also Block123 has a list of all the DeFi or decentralized finance projects out there like Maker, DAI, Compound, Dharma, 0x, Bancor, and so forth. A lot of innovation and development going on in the space, and also people are actually putting through significant amount of money in these decentralized finance protocols too. And finally, we have big development milestones coming up soon for many projects like Ethereum 2.0 starting in early 2020. We've been waiting a long time for this. Also new development updates for NEO, for EOS, Cardano, and so forth. Another topic we kind of want to explore is the reasoning why altcoins were dampened in the first place. Now, of course, it was just rampant speculation, a lot of buzz and empty promises, a lot of scams like critics or maximalists say. But another big reason why the market dampened was because of regulators coming out and putting a brake on this whole industry. They take time, of course. We know regulation takes time and it's slow, but there's progress in this space and stuff that makes me hopeful for regulation that's potentially friendly or at least brings clarity for the crypto space. So for example, at the G20 summit, they explicitly discussed frameworks for decentralized and digital assets. And so this has the top powers in the world putting effort, putting eyes, and wanting to move the discussion along. Furthermore, we have countries already come out with clear frameworks like Malta, like Singapore and Thailand, countries that want to invite the business over to their country to increase innovation as a whole. And finally, this is very recent, but very big news. Recently, Blockstack received SEC qualification, the first ever SEC approved token offering in US history. Also, another really large argument that maximalists make is that institutional money, when it comes in, it's only gonna go towards Bitcoin. But that is something I also disagree with, and here's a few reasons why. First of all, here is an example of a $100 million crypto fund opening with the goal of going long for digital assets such as Ether, and this is called Dharma Capital. I'm just gonna quote this here on Bloomberg, are counting on Ether's long-term integral role in the Ethereum's blockchain. And you can do some more research and reading on this yourself. Also, Andreessen Horowitz, one of the largest and most storied venture capitalist firms of all time, also started a large crypto fund as well called A16Z Crypto. And you can read more about what they're investing in, but basically they're doing a lot of investment on different coins like Definity, Coinbase, DYDX, Filecoin, Maker, Libra, and so forth. Definitely not showing signs that they're only interested in Bitcoin. Finally, if you just take a look at blockchain venture capital on CoinDesk, you can go to CoinDesk Data and Research and look here. If you click into yearly VC funding for blockchain projects, you can see how the number of rounds have rocketed even in 2018, even in the depth of crypto winter. VCs are still interested in the space and not only in Bitcoin related stuff. So interesting stuff, Kevin, right? But what does this mean in terms of our own investment strategy? Well, I don't want to be giving investment advice, of course, but this is just my personal opinion I want to share with you. Of course, I still think Bitcoin is the safest asset and you should be mostly in it while it keeps on running and altcoins stay mostly stagnant. And even if you take a look at last time's rise, Bitcoin started its massive parabolic move earlier and then alts followed later. And so is that gonna happen this time? No one really knows. History doesn't have to repeat itself, but it's something to keep an eye on and something you may want to risk manage properly in your portfolio. Especially since this is always gonna be true, even if Bitcoin stays king forever, it's still most likely that it has less room to run than other altcoins. So you should keep that in mind when you set your portfolio allocations properly and risk manage, of course. So in conclusion, once again, it's my opinion that solid alts will recover one day. Who knows when? It may be a long time from now, but hopefully sooner rather than later. And even if that's the case, there's no guarantees that the ones that you like, the ones that you hold it back for, will recover. So keep that in mind as well. Now, as far as Bitcoin maximalists go, they are really loud on crypto Twitter, on YouTube, and so forth. But of course, we'll have to put up with what they say for now. But I think, my personal opinion, that they're going to end up like Noriel Rubini, who is a critic of even Bitcoin. And during crypto winter of 2018, he was loud, kind of patting his own back, super smug the entire time. But when Bitcoin rose from 3,000 to over 10,000, he was pretty silent. And people were laughing at him, saying, where did Noriel Rubini go? So I may be totally wrong. I'm not Nostradamus. I have a feeling that Bitcoin maximalists are going to follow in the footsteps of Noriel Rubini and being silent when altcoins have their day once again. So what are your thoughts, everyone? Thank you for watching. I hope you check out some of our other videos as well, but let me know your thoughts on Bitcoin versus altcoin seasons down in the comments below. If you're a maximalist or still a believer in alt projects, I'd love to hear your thoughts. This is Kevin from Bitcoin for Beginners, and I'll catch you guys next time.